The role of a student at Slavic Missionary Bible School is to not only gain a deep and powerful understanding of the Word of God, but also to be given the tools to put their faith and extensive knowledge of Scripture into practice. Once a week, groups of students participate in different evangelical activities designed to provide avenues for spiritual growth through ministering and applications of Scripture reviewed in the classroom. Some of these activities include ministering at a juvenile detention center, on the street, and at a local homeless shelter. These activities provide a means for God to strengthen students by working through them to bring people in desperate need to Jesus Christ. Slavic Missionary Bible students are able to grow and reach new levels of spiritual strength as they continue their walk with God.
Step out on a busy street, see a girl and our eyes meet, does her best to smile at me, to hide what's underneath. There's a man just to arrive, black suit and a bright red tie, too ashamed to tell his wife he's out of work, he's buying time. All those people going somewhere, why have I never cared? Give me your eyes for just one second, give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity, give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten, give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah, 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 yeah. I've been here a million times, a couple of million eyes, just moving past me by, I swear I never thought that I was wrong. Well, I want a second glance, so give me a second chance to see the way you see the people all along. Give me your eyes for just one second.
Vita, how has homeless shelter affected you?
Going to homeless shelters has helped me learn how to serve others and just to shine Christ's love in simple things like handing out food or giving somebody a drink of water.
When I was in the homeless shelter, I talked to one gentleman and he said that God changed his life, and when he's gonna go home, he's gonna go back to church.
Because every time we go to the homeless shelter and we give out food to them, you can see the smiles that they have on their faces and they really enjoy it. And all they need is someone to talk to and someone to listen to their problems.
Ruslana, tell us how street ministry has affected you.
Me coming to Bible school, one of my biggest fears was to come up and talk to unbelievers. I wasn't sure of what I was supposed to say. And at Bible school, we learned a lot of useful tips how to talk to people. And I had to overcome my fear of going out there and just preaching the gospel. And I learned a lot of useful tips, and it really affected me for the future.
The one thing that really touched me was at the end of our street ministry, we were praying, and then a lady came up to us and asked us to pray for her. And it was out of the ordinary because she just came out of the blue and asked us to pray for her. When we prayed for her, everybody around us looked, and there was this joy that prayer gave us.
What inspired me in street ministry is that, first of all, it helped me get out of my comfort zone. And second of all, when you talk to people, it actually inspires you more and keeps you stronger in faith.
It was when we went to the beach and we ended up singing and praying with a group of homeless people. There was a lot of us there. And at the end, one of the homeless people actually came up to one of our guys and was like, "Today I gave my life away to Jesus." And it really inspired me. And really, like, after that, I really wanted to do stuff like street ministry. And
there's three categories of homeless people. There's one that actually have financial problems and live in the street. Second one is mentally sick people. Third one is people that actually like that way of living. They don't want to work. And us going out there to the streets and helping them inspires me and teaches me to help others in need. And it shows the homeless people that there are people that care about them.
One of the days we were walking with our group, and I had been wearing the SMBS sweatshirt. And in the back it said, Mark 16:15, go preach to all nations. And so there was a guy walking behind us, and he saw that shirt and he commented on it. And he said his name was Mark. And that pretty much sparked up the conversation, and we started preaching to him. So that just kind of showed me that we really just need to always, everywhere we go, be the light, and even things like our clothes can represent that.
Christina, how has jail ministry affected you?
It was really unexpected to see that the kids were so open and willing to talk to us when we came there and did our program. And it definitely inspired me to start a jail ministry at home where I'm from in Atlanta.
Jail ministry has given me the opportunity to come to jail and share the gospel with the young woman and just be a good example to them, tell them about God and that Jesus loves them, that they're not just out there by themselves, that somebody out there in the world just truly loves them.
When we came there as a group, I saw that we were just like the light, and when I was talking to a couple of younger boys, I just answered their questions, and I could tell they really appreciated that there's somebody there that can talk to them about Christ and answer their questions that may have been in their hearts for a while.
When I went to jail ministry, I was able to talk to 3 girls, and I was inspired to go and preach to more people after I talked to them. I was able to share God's love, and through that, I want to go and talk to more people about God.
I believe it was an awesome experience where we were given the opportunity to be the light to the juveniles at the jail center who are our own age, and they listened to us, and we were able to show them an example, talk to them about their various experiences, how they got there, and what changes they're going to do to get out of there. I think personally it really affected me in a good way, and now I'm not as judgmental, and I believe I was able to give some good advice.